Monopoly, a game that provides both hours of entertainment and a good excuse to ruthlessly cut down friends and family members. And it turns out there are a few math-based tricks that make winning easier. Monopoly is a classic game of chance, which means moves can be estimated with probability calculations. We can use them to actually determine where the board's hotspots are and how well specific investments can pay off. First off, you need to understand the vehicle of the game, the dice. Basic probability tells us rolling two dice will result in a 7 more often than any other number. So right off the first roll of the game, you're most likely to land on one of these spots. You can also use this trick to plan when and where to build houses. If you just landed on New York Avenue and there's someone behind you on St. Charles Place, it might be a good time to build some property. Chance and community chest cards also have a big effect on the game. Any of 5 things may happen to you when you draw one of these cards. You either pay money, receive money, go to jail, get out of jail, or move to a different spot on the board. 9 of the 16 cards in each deck require you to move, specifically to one of these spaces. Aside from pulling an unlucky card, you can also get sent to jail if you land on the go to jail space, or if you roll 3 doubles in a row, known in the game as speeding. This can happen more often than you'd think. The probability of rolling 3 doubles is about 0.4%, but multiplied over the course of a game, or 50 player turns, it gives you a 20% chance of going to prison for speeding. So watch it, punk. With 4 possible routes, you're more likely to land on jail than any other individual space. It's actually the most visited space on the board. This means the row following jail is also frequently visited. Specifically these spots, taking into account our roll probability stats. So with all this data, we can actually figure exact percentages for how often each spot is visited. The high levels of traffic in these areas mean they're probably a good place to invest, whereas you may want to stay away from these neighborhoods. So now we know where the prime real estate is, but how much should we cash in on these locations? Blogger Truman Collins used the probabilities of landing on each space to calculate the approximate number of opponent rolls it would take to earn back any investment. The spaces in red show faster recouped costs. As you can see, you shouldn't hesitate to build that third house or to buy those additional railroads. So to recap, remember that 6, 7, and 8 are the most commonly rolled numbers. You can use this to trap trailing opponents into paying rent. Jail is the axis of the board, meaning the properties following it are frequently visited, specifically these ones. Buy them. 3 houses is the sweet spot. In all cases but one, building 3 houses will allow you to recover your investment the quickest. Keeping this math in mind, you'll be ruling the Monopoly board in no time. Just try not to let it go to your head.